Alright, what's going on everybody? In this video, I gotta explain interfaces using Java. An interface is very similar to an abstract class. In fact, there's a lot of overlap where you could use either one, but there's a few key differences. An interface is a blueprint for a class. It specifies a set of abstract methods that any implementing classes must define. One key difference is that by using interfaces, we can achieve multiple inheritance-like behavior. Normally with inheritance, a class can only have a single parent. But by using interfaces, a class can have multiple parents, like 2, 3, or more. So in this demonstration, we're going to create two interfaces. Let's go to File, New, Java Class. Rather than creating a class, we're going to create an interface. We will create an interface of Prey, and the other for Predator. File, New, Java Class, Interface, Predator. We're going to be declaring some methods, but not defining them. If a class inherits from the prey interface, they will have to finish defining a method of flee. The return type will be void. If you're considered prey, you need a flee method to run away. If you're a predator, you need to define a method to hunt, because you're a predator. Now we'll be creating three classes. File, New, Java class. The first class will be rabbit. Then fish, we'll create a fish class, and hawk. Going to our rabbit class, rabbits are typically considered prey, not predators. Unless you count that one rabbit from Monty Python and the Holy Grail, that's the exception. Our rabbit class is going to implement the prey interface. We get a warning message. Class rabbit must either declare abstract or implement abstract method flee. Since the rabbit class is implementing the prey interface, we have to finish defining this method that's declared within the prey interface. It's kind of like a contract. The prey interface is telling the rabbit class, hey, if you're going to implement me, you need to define this method of flee. We'll need to do that in order to create rabbit objects. We're going to be overriding this method using the override annotation. This method will be flee, void flee. And we'll want to add this access modifier of public. It's a publicly accessible method. In this method, we're going to output the following. Let's say the rabbit is running away. And that error should go away. Let's go back to our main class. We'll create a rabbit object and test it. Rabbit, rabbit equals new rabbit. Let's take our rabbit object, have it call the flee method. And this should work. Yes, the rabbit is running away. Now let's go to our hawk class. Hawk will implement the predator interface. But we have to override this method of hunt. Because with the predator interface, it's kind of like we're signing a contract. If hawk is going to implement the predator interface, then we have to finish defining this method. We will add the at override annotation and define this method. And then again, we do need an access modifier. We'll pick public. Let's output the following. The hawk is hunting. Let's create a hawk object. Hawk, hawk equals new hawk. Our rabbit is fleeing. Let's take our hawk object, use the hunt method. Okay, we have the rabbit is running away, the hawk is hunting. Now, rabbits don't have a hunt method, and hawks don't have a flee method. Now, one key difference with interfaces compared to abstract classes is that you can implement more than one interface. So fish, they eat smaller fish, and they flee larger fish. They could be considered both prey and predators. We will implement two interfaces, implements prey, comma, predator. Then we need both of these methods. We have to finish defining both. Again, we're going to use the at override annotation. We will create a publicly accessible method, a flee, where we will print the fish is swimming away. And we need a hunt method too. Add the at override annotation. This is a public method of hunt, where we will print the fish is hunting, let's say. All right, let's test it. We will create a fish object. Fish, fish equals new fish. Our fish can flee, and our fish can hunt. The fish is swimming away, the fish is hunting. Our fish object implements both the prey and predator interfaces. It has to define these two methods. So that's one key difference with interfaces compared to abstract classes. A class can inherit more than one interface. Normally with inheritance, you can only have one parent. But this is a way around that using interfaces. Fish are considered both prey and predators. Alright everybody, so that is a quick introduction to interfaces. An interface is a blueprint for a class that specifies a set of abstract methods that implementing classes must define, and it supports multiple inheritance-like behavior. There's a lot of overlap where you can use abstract classes or interfaces. You should be familiar with both. And well, everybody, that's a quick introduction to interfaces using Java.